really.
Thank you very much.
So why am I going to Geneva? The CEO of Audemars Piguet came to LSE for a talk. Towards the end of his talk, he said, any questions? And I raised up my hand. I asked him, he brought a watch which was 280,000 pounds. And I said, I have a question. Would you mind selling me this watch right now? I really want to see your sales approach on how you sell a 280,000 pound watch.
Okay. You're going to tour the factory, okay? And then you tell me about not wearing ever a watch again.
Sure, okay.
Now, what's your first name?
Bilal.
Bilal, how many know him in the room? Wait, what are you doing here? Nobody knows you here?
Two. But now maybe they will want to.
Or they will never see your cute face again. Because when you are in Switzerland, if you don't decide to buy a watch, I'm going to bury you there. Have you seen Bernard? No. Okay? But...
Okay, so he's invited to come to Le Brasseur, visit the factory, but if he doesn't buy a watch, he's dead. And he's dead. Okay?
Yeah. With the cheese.
Thank you. Bye. So now I'm about to board my plane, go to Geneva, meet him tomorrow. Let's see. After a 2 hours long flight, I finally landed in Geneva. As soon as I step out of the plane into the airport, all I see around me is watches and watches everywhere.
Thank you very much.
At 9 a.m. from Geneva, we are going to the headquarters of Audemars Piguet, which is 1 hour away from us. They've come to pick us up in this beautiful Maserati. As you can see, we have some in-flight entertainment as well, and we have some gift hampers by AP.
Oh, so I have some nice gloves. I can wear them, and this is before I steal the most expensive watch they have with my James Bond gloves.
So I am trying to get my pronunciation right with the name. So Oliver, the name is Bennahmias. No. Bennahmias. So when I'm interviewing him, I call him with the right name. What was it again? Scenes I have ever seen in my life.
Yeah, good.
Guys, these must be, camera cannot do justice to these scenes. These are perhaps the most beautiful scenes I have ever seen in my life. You just look back,
and see. Look at those scenes. Look at those scenes. Oh my God, this is like paradise.
This is the AP headquarters.
Here, just here. Hello, hi. I'm good, thank you. How are you? Nice to meet you.
Welcome.
Yeah.
So we have our tour guide and her name is Veronique. Veronique, how long have you been working with Audemars Piguet?
12 years.
12 years. Yes. You must be enjoying this weather by now.
Yes, yes. I rather like the snow, I must say.
Jules-Louis Audemars, Edouard Auguste Piguet. And here are the two families. We have Madame Audemars and Olivier Audemars.
So this is where the brand Audemars Piguet was started by these two gentlemen in 1875. And this was the actual house where the watchmaking began. And today it's one of the most prestigious brands in the world.
Hello.
Hello.
Good
to see you.
Oh, right. Hello. Hello. How are you? Bilal, nice to see you. With you, yes.
After, you know, your talk at LSE, and there was a particular event, you know, a particular question that I asked you, which of course ignited you to, you know, say that why don't you come to visit us in the world headquarters of Audemars Piguet. And
Audemars Piguet.
Audemars Piguet, sorry.
He's saying the wrong way.
No, I
say this one more time. Audemars.
Piguet.
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 Piguet. Piguet. Hi, yeah, yeah, yeah. Easy.
I've got it.
Okay, you are. Control.
You want to be in control.
You got to eat, because if you don't eat and it's warm, you got to be in trouble. You know that.
Yeah, yeah. It's fine. You are more important than the food. So please, you carry on. You carry on. It'll be good. Okay, I get that. So, did you receive a call from Jack Ma?
No.
No?
No.
Are you still waiting?
No.
This week, India's richest guy, Mukesh Ambani, 54 billion worth, mm-hmm. His daughter got married. Beyonce flew in specially for that event. Did you sell any watches for that event, for that marriage?
No.
You and I have one thing in common.
Which is?
You have a foundation and I have a foundation.
Okay.
I'm talking about the AP Foundation.
Mm-hmm.
You are in the business of time, but you agree that doesn't matter how much money you have, you can't buy time.
Mm-hmm.
But you can obviously gift time.
Mm-hmm.
By gifting, I mean that I have a foundation where women and children in underdeveloped part of the world, they have to travel across long distances, 3 to 4 hours every single day to just fetch water, bring water on top of their heads. And we give them a wheel which carries up to 40 liters of water. It's an easy drag on. And your clients have this prestige when they buy an expensive watch. You know, it's an introduction. They've treated themselves. You know, it's something to be proud of. Have you ever thought of running a marketing campaign, or do you think it's relevant based on the foundation and how, you know, your client who feels good after buying that watch? And because I believe people buy based on emotions and then they try to justify it with logic. Facts can only tell, but it's the stories that sell.
Mm-hmm.
So adding more emotion in terms of making them feel consciously better, that as much, you know, up until this clock is ticking, I am adding in somebody else's life, adding value into mm-hmm. somebody else's life. Because watch is something you will wear through your highs and lows. So it's a good conscious feeling. Have you ever tried to capitalize on this social angle with your clients? Do they even care about this?
Sure, they do care. And most of them, in certain countries more than others, obviously, a lot of people give a lot of money to different charities.
Okay, so he said, first of all, it's Audemars Piguet, which is I don't even know what that is. And then he said, Franquio. So now, I know your name is Bilal, but from now on, we'll be Bilul or Bilil.
Or whatever.
Or whatever. Okay?
You can call me Arnold. I know you are good friends with him. Or Muhammad Ali.
No, not the same shape. Not the same shape. Doesn't work.
Yeah, I know I'm better. Actually, I know I'm better.
You're better? I'm not sure at all, actually. No.
Depending on the taste.
No. So we're talking about? Yes?
How do you want to be remembered? Of course, you have changed.
A people's person.
People's person.
A people's person.
It's the most talented place in the world. Where you find all sorts of talent, all sorts of talents. Singing, dancing, music, boxing, guitar, acting. You find the most talent. Where?
No clue.
You know, based on the Yoda, you want to zoom back in, do or do not, and there is no try. You want to come back? I think. Based on this premise, the most talented place on the world is graveyards. Because there's so much untapped talent that died only because they didn't try.
This has to be Nobel Prize minimum. minimum. This is huge. I'm gonna use that one actually.
What are you doing here?
Write books! Talk to people!
I love talking to people. I might have cancer next week. We never know. There are people of my age who sleep and don't wake up.
Now, next time you come here or I see your face and you fuck up my name, I'll take your eyes off your face and I'll eat them in front of you. You won't be able to see it, but you will feel it. Do you hear me, Bilal?
Can I ask a question? Would you grill the eyes or would you like to have it?
No, raw.
Very
Japanese style.
Okay. Thank you very much for your time. It's
good pleasure. To see you.
I hope there are more CEOs like you leading more companies. They would, you know, people like you have a contagious effect in the room you walk in, and that would help a lot more people in terms of entrepreneur and motivate, because if you've made it, everyone else can make it as well.
As stupid as I am, if I made it, so many people can make it. Yeah.
You're just being humble.
Thank you.
So, a very interesting topic which was discussed with the CEO was that what's the difference between a failure and a success? The difference is trying. The difference is actually doing. And he strongly believes in that as well. People think too much, people feel too much, but the world doesn't remember these people. The world remembers the people who do, who have the guts to go out and embarrass themselves and face failure and be resilient. Be like this. You have to be like this. This rock. This small rock that is breaking the wave. You have to be like that. You have to stay steady, stay resilient. And only then you become somebody who leaves a bigger impact than just the impact you are leaving as a human being on this earth.